Hi, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about ID scanning. A few months ago, I wrote an app that does ID scanning and does the date math for you to figure out whether somebody's 21 or not. I just wanted to shoot a quick video to see what all is involved with ID scanning, the pitfalls, privacy concerns, etc. So stay tuned. I'm going to go over this with you in detail. Okay, I'm first going to show you kind of what the app does. I've got some IDs splayed out here. I realize these are not real IDs. These are what's on the back of almost every U.S. ID out there now. This does do all 50 states. And for the most part, everything that is on the front of the ID or the license is encoded on the rear of the license. And here's its operation. You can pretty much quickly go over and scan IDs. It just takes a brief second. There's age 19, age 25, age 25 but expired. So pretty much what this app is doing is it's doing the date math for you. So it will give you their age and tell you whether they're over 21 or not in just a few seconds. So if you were a wait staff or bartender, etc., you could really quickly verify the date math of what their ID has on the back to make sure they're of age. I have four here. These are various states. This particular one here is encoded in the format, but does not have all the information. And this ID scanner is smart enough to pull out the relevant information. The only thing that it's really looking for, it will display everything that it can on the screen. But the main thing it's looking for is what is their date of birth. That's one of the most difficult things to do. Every ID from almost every state that I've seen does not actually show their age, obviously, because it's a moving target. They'll do date of birth, and it's up to you to figure out whether they're actually 21 or not. Now, one thing I'll say about all ID scanners, there's no fake ID detection in my app and in most other apps out there, including the big expensive there's $1,000 ID scanners out there that do not detect fake IDs. They're doing something very similar. They may be looking for watermarks, etc., but that's something that each individual server should be looking for. You should hold the ID in your hand and make your own determination on whether you think that ID is fake. Another thing to check, this will decode a lot of the information that is on the rear of the ID. You want to make sure that matches with the front of the ID. I'll put a link to my particular app down in the description if you're interested in that. One thing that I did do, it's basically one price and you can scan as many IDs as you want. You basically get free updates, etc. But as you can see, I could go around the table really quick and scan. You can scan an ID about once every 2 seconds. It actually gives you, you won't be able to see this in the video, but you can see here it's kind of showing a green thumbs up kind of notation. Not everyone out there can actually see green, so it actually adds a visual indicator to show thumbs up or thumbs down on the age. It displays whether their license is expired or not. That may be important to you, and obviously their name. Another thing that I'll mention, I really strived in this particular app, I'm a big proponent of privacy. This does not actually store any data. It is a, basically a scan, show, and then it fades away into the background. It's not storing any data or sending any data anywhere, which is important to the person that you're scanning their ID to let them know that you're not storing that data or using it, because it basically is all of the data, which you really don't need to have other than just, to make sure it's not fake, for the purposes of determining whether someone is of age or not. I'll kind of give you a, so we've scanned this. If you hold this here, it kind of stays in the foreground and slowly fades off and it's gone. And you can actually scan again. It'll give you a little bit of haptic feedback if you have a newer iPhone to let you know that it's good or bad. It'll have a different feedback for good or bad. So I'm just scanning here at different angles. It really does not matter which angle. You just need to kind of get the barcode anywhere in the picture. It'll draw a green line around it when it sees it and instantly display the data. do a couple more. Hopefully that comes through on the camera. I'm doing off angle scans, and it scans really fast. This works really well in almost all environments. There is a feature if you are at a nighttime bar setting, especially if you're at the door and you need to scan in low light. There's a button down at the very bottom. It's called torch. And as you can see, it turns on the torch, and as soon as it scans, it turns it back off, so it doesn't stay on. So it makes it really convenient to do in the dark, to scan IDs in the dark. This is iOS only. It works on iOS iPhones, iOS iPads. For those that aren't familiar with the channel, I do a lot of programming work. I have done STM8 introduction. The Razer MUX had a lot of C code that actually made that embedded controller work. This particular project is something new to me, which I've been learning the past few years since it started really hitting mainstream. And pretty much, if you're doing iOS development, you're learning Swift probably. Prior to this, I've written several Objective-C iOS applications, both on the desktop and here. Swift is new, and I really like it. If you have not looked at it, take a look. If you have a Linux machine, you can get Swift on that as well. It's a very convenient language, and it prevents you from writing mistakes. It makes really good code, really fast. It's relatively fast to learn. And all of this app is written in Swift, which is the latest technology from Apple. ID scanning is very important. Anytime that you're handing someone your ID and they're scanning the back of it, just always keep in mind, unless it's an app like I've written, that data is probably being stored somewhere, and it's everything that's on the front of your ID. So use caution. A lot of places, they will not let you in. I've even been to like trade shows and stuff where they scan that information, to get mailing addresses, your name, and everything, which is probably a valid use, and that's a decision that I made, getting into the trade show. It's giving them my information. But all the contents in this, if you looked at this raw format, basically it's everything that's on the front of the ID. There are a few exceptions, there's a few check digits and stuff like that are not on the front of the ID, which are not super useful information or considered like a privacy issue other than your actual information. So keep that in mind. Anyway, I hope this video is helpful. If you need this app, I'll put this app down at the bottom. It's low cost, not by scan. It's literally pay once, and you can do as many scans as you want, and you get all free updates in the future. Again, I do not have an Android version of this. This is iOS. I've got a big Windrock trip planned, and I'll be shooting most of that hopefully next week, and be putting out some videos soon after. I really appreciate all the new subscribers. It keeps an upward momentum. I really appreciate that. That kind of motivates me to keep doing videos. And if you haven't subscribed, please consider clicking on that subscribe button, and definitely click on the bell. It'll make sure you get all the new content that comes out. And by all means, if you have any comments, questions, if you want to debate something, feel free to leave a comment. I try to respond to all comments that I can, if they're a reasonable request. Anyway, we'll see you on the next video, and thanks again.